Hello students, welcome back to the BEE class. It's the second lecture on unit 3, single phase AC circuit. This was the syllabus of unit 3. In first lecture, we have covered this much portion of the syllabus. In this lecture, I'll try to cover the syllabus this much. Okay, so this will be the second lecture. Let us preview what we have seen in the last lecture. We have seen pure resistance, pure inductance and pure capacitance. What was the opposition factor to the flow of current? In pure resistance, it was resistance. In pure inductance, there was only L. Therefore, the opposing factor will be XL, which is called as inductive reactance. The formula for inductive reactance is omega L. What is omega? Omega is 2 pi F. Therefore, omega L will be 2 pi FL. The unit of XL is same as resistance. It's ohm. What is the opposition factor in pure capacitance? It is XC, capacitive reactance, given by 1 by omega C is equal to 1 by 2 pi FC. Again the same, its unit will be ohm. The next is phase angle. We have derived the derivation of current instantaneous power. From those derivations, we got to know the phase angle for the different cases. For pure resistance, the phase angle was 0, which is also called as the in phase. For pure inductance, the phase angle between voltage and current was pi by 2. Pi by 2 is 90 degree. Okay, the current was lagging behind the voltage by 90 degree. For lagging, negative sign is there. Okay. For pure capacitance, the phase angle between voltage and current was pi by 2. But the current was leading to the voltage by 90 degree. For leading, positive sign is there. Okay. See, this is the voltage equation. The voltage equation is same for all the cases. V is equal to Vm sine omega t. For pure resistance, I is equal to Im sine omega t with phi is equal to 0. This is what? Phi. For inductance, I is equal to Im sine omega t minus pi by 2. The current is lagging behind this voltage by pi by 2. Lagging negative. Pi by 2 means 90 degree. Okay. Next, for pure capacitance, the current equation will be I is equal to Im sin omega t plus pi by 2. Instead of minus pi by 2 for capacitance, it will be plus pi by 2. Now, if I is equal to Im sin omega t, see the difference between these two. If V is equal to Vm sin omega t, these are the equations of current. Now we are assuming that if I is equal to Im sin omega t, what will be the different equation for the different cases of voltage? Okay. If I is equal to Im sin omega t for pure resistance, since phi is equal to 0, there will not be phi in this equation. Therefore, V is equal to Vm sin of omega t. For pure inductance, since the current was lagging, it means the voltage will lead. By what angle? By angle pi by 2. Therefore, if I is equal to Im sin omega t, V will be Vm sin omega t plus pi by 2. In the case of capacitance, since the current was leading, or we can say the voltage was lagging, right? Therefore, if I is equal to Im sin omega t, what will be the voltage equation? It will be V is equal to Vm sin omega t minus pi by 2. Okay. From this equation, we have derived the instantaneous power. From the instantaneous power, we have derived the average power consumed by the different cases for pure resistance, for pure inductance and for pure capacitance. For pure resistance, we observe that the power absorbed by resistance is equal to what? Voltage into current, where V and I are the RMS value of voltage and RMS value of current. For the remaining two cases, for pure inductance and for pure capacitance, we have observed that in both the cases, power is not absorbed. The average power is equal to zero. They never consumes power. Inductance as well as capacitance, they never consumes power. Do remember, in question, if they ask to calculate the power absorbed under the case of pure inductance or in pure capacitance, you no need to carry the power. You can directly write power is equal to zero, since pure inductance or pure capacitance never consumes power. Next, frequency of power. From the instantaneous power equation, we got to know that the frequency of the power was double than the supplied frequency. If F was the supply frequency, the frequency of power was what? Twice of F or twice of omega. This is the same for all the cases. In a single cycle of voltage, we have seen that there is a double cycle of the power. This is nothing but double the frequency than the applied voltage. If V is equal to V at an angle 0, if V is equal to V at an angle 0, this V shows the magnitude of the voltage, whereas this 0 shows the angle of the voltage. Okay. Therefore, under the pure resistance, what will be the I? I is equal to I at an angle 0, where this I is RMS value of current. Do remember, in some books, this I is considered as maximum current. But do remember, this is RMS value of current. It is not maximum value of current. So, I is equal to I RMS at an angle 0. For pure inductance, what will be I? I is equal to I at an angle what? Minus 90 degree. If V is starting at 0, the current will start after 90 degree. Okay, therefore minus 90 degree. These equations are required when we are plotting the phasor diagram. Okay, while plotting the phasor diagram, the minus 90 degree means the current is lagging behind the voltage by angle 90 degree. So, where to draw the current phasor? If the voltage phasor is drawn at positive x-axis, this current phasor is to be drawn after 90 degree. Minus 90 degree means what? Lagging. Lagging should be drawn in a clockwise direction. Therefore, from the positive x-axis at 90 degree, draw the I in clockwise direction. Okay. Opposite to this, for pure capacitance, I will be I at an angle plus 90 degree. Plus 90 degree will be in an anti-clockwise direction. From positive x-axis, take the current phasor at 90 degree in an anti-clockwise direction. Power factor. Power factor is given by formula cos phi. The power factor for pure resistance, what is it? What is it? It is unity. 1. The power factor for inductance, it is XL. Sorry, it is lagging. Lagging because of this negative sign. The power factor for capacitance, see, there is plus sign. For plus sign, the power factor will be leading one. Okay. This was the recalling of the first lecture. Let us start with the second. So, second lecture. Under the second lecture, the very first content is series, resistance and inductance, or AC applied to resistance and inductance. Consider an AC circuit with a resistance and inductance of L Henry. Both of them are connected in series as shown in this figure. And the alternating voltage of magnitude V is equal to Vm sin of omega t is applied to this series combination. Okay. The current flowing in the circuit is I. The voltage across the resistance, the voltage dropped across this resistance will be Vr. The voltage drop across this inductor will be VL. Vr is the voltage drop across the resistance, which is given by the formula I into R, voltage drop across the R. We know that for pure resistance, the current and voltage both are in phase. Both are in phase. There is no phase angle between voltage and current. Therefore, both are parallel to each other. What is VL? VL is voltage across, voltage drop across the inductor. Okay. Therefore, its value will be I into its opposition. Opposition of inductor is given by XL. Okay. Therefore, VL will be equal to I into XL. We also know that for pure inductor, the current lags behind the voltage across the inductor by 90 degree. See, for lagging, the current phasor is shown in clockwise direction after angle 90 degree. With this information, we can draw the phasor diagram. How to plot the phasor diagram? In this case, both the parameters are connected in series, and we know that in series current remains same. Therefore, we have taken the current phasor as a reference phasor. This is the current phasor which we have taken as a reference phasor. The voltage Vr, it is in phase with I. For pure resistance, voltage and current both are in phase. The voltage VL, the voltage VL, it will lead this current by angle 90 degree, or this current is lagging behind the voltage by angle 90 degree. Okay. Therefore, the resultant voltage V can be drawn like this, which will be the vector addition of this Vr and this VL. From this phasor diagram, we can observe that the total voltage is leading the total current by some angle. That angle is called as phase angle phi. The voltage is leading the current by angle phi, or in other words, we can say the current is lagging behind the voltage by some angle phi. Right? From this, we can have the equations of voltage and current. If V is equal to Vm sin omega t, what will be the equation of current? It will be Im sin of omega t. Since the current is lagging, therefore minus phi. Are you getting? We have considered the equation of V as V is equal to Vm sin omega t. Therefore, I will be what? Since the I is lagging, I is in clockwise direction with V. It means it is lagging. Therefore, I is equal to Im sin of omega t minus phi. From this phasor diagram, we can also draw the waveforms. Okay. This is the waveform of voltage and current. The voltage equation, V is equal to Vm sin omega t. There is no phi. Therefore, this voltage waveform will start from the zero axis. It will complete its cycle. At 90 degree, it will reach to positive maximum value. At 180 degree, will complete the positive half cycle. At 270, will reach to negative maximum. And at 360 degree, it will complete its one cycle. Next, we have to draw the waveform of current. Since current is Im sin of omega t minus phi. Minus is for lagging. Lagging means later. If V has started at a zeroth angle, the current will start after some angle phi. This is angle phi. This is also called as the phase difference between voltage and current. The current will start at this particular point. The current will reach to its maximum value. the difference between the current's maximum value and voltage maximum value is also phi. The current will complete its positive half cycle at this instant. The difference between this point and this point is also phi. The current will complete its cycle at this particular point, which will be obviously after this voltage. And the angle between this is also phi. Are you getting this? How to draw the waveforms? Again, for simplicity, the phasor diagram is drawn. Okay. The V can be also written as V is equal to V at an angle 0, where this is RMS value of voltage and this is the phase angle of voltage. Since phi is equal to 0, therefore it is drawn in parallel with positive x axis. I is equal to I at an angle minus phi. Therefore, the I phasor is drawn after angle phi at this particular point. Are you getting? Minus, therefore in clockwise direction. From the first diagram, V was equal to what? Vr, the vector addition of voltage. V is equal to Vr plus Vl, voltage across the resistance, voltage across the inductor. Mathematically, we can write V is equal to square root of Vr square plus Vl square. From this, what is Vr? Vr is equal to Ir. What is Vl? Vl is equal to I into XL. Therefore, V is equal to square root of under the bracket Ir square plus in bracket IXL bracket square. Okay. Taking I common, therefore V becomes V is equal to I square root of R square plus XL square, where this R square plus XL square is equal to Z. Square root of R square plus XL square is also called as Z. What is Z? Z is the impedance. What is impedance? Impedance is the opposition offered by the entire AC circuit. It is similar to the resistance in DC circuit. Okay, where Z will be R plus XL. Do remember, in DC there was only one opposition by the resistance, but in AC circuit the opposition by the resistance and the opposition by the inductor and capacitor should also be considered. Z is equal to V upon I. Same as resistance, R is equal to V upon I. Z is equal to square root of R square plus XL square. What will be the unit of this Z? It is same as the resistance, ohms. Okay. Next, calculating the phase angle and the power factor cos phi from the very first diagram itself. Okay. What is tan phi of this diagram? Tan phi of this diagram is equal to opposite side divided by adjacent side. Opposite side to this angle phi is VL and adjacent side is VR. What is VL? VL is equal to I into XL. What is VR? It is I into R. II cancel, therefore tan phi is equal to XL divided by R. From this, phi is equal to what? Taking this tan to right hand side, it will become tan inverse into bracket XL divided by R. In exam, it is asked to calculate this angle phi for the case RL. Which formula will be using? Phi is equal to tan inverse XL divided by R. Okay. The next is power factor. Power factor is given by cos phi. What is cos phi of this angle, triangle? The cos phi will be adjacent side divided by hypotenuse side. Adjacent side is VR, hypotenuse side is V. What is VR? VR is I into R. What is V? It is I into Z. Entire voltage, entire current, entire opposition. Okay, II cancel, therefore cos phi is equal to what? R by Z. At any time you can calculate power factor by the ratio of resistance to the impedance. At the last, we got to know that in case of series RL circuit, the current lags behind the applied voltage by an angle phi, where V is equal to Vm sin omega t, I is equal to Im sin of omega t. The next is impedance triangle. The impedance is given by the formula Z is equal to square root of R square plus XL square. Okay, how to draw this? Phi is equal to tan inverse of XL divided by R. How to get this impedance triangle? It is very simple. It is obtained from this particular triangle, voltage triangle. This is voltage triangle. This side is VR, opposite side is VL, and hypotenuse side is V. Sorry, not multiplying. We have to divide all the side by the current. What is VR divided by I? V upon I is opposition. This is resistive side. V upon I gives the resistance. VL upon I, the opposition for the inductor is XL. V upon I, the opposition will be Z. Phi as it is. This triangle which is giving opposition in all the sides is called as impedance triangle. This is resistance, inductive reactance, and this is impedance. Complex notation of impedance. If V is equal to V at an angle 0, I is equal to I at an angle minus of phi. Since current was lagging, therefore minus phi. How to get the impedance? Impedance is the ratio of voltage to current V, V at an angle 0 divided by I at an angle minus phi. Mathematically, it will become V upon I, an angle. This angle will go in numerator and will become positive. 0 minus minus will become plus positive. For dividation, we have to take the subtraction of the angle. So, it will become positive phi. What is V by I? V by I is Z at an angle phi. This impedance can be represented by this equation. Z is equal to Z at an angle plus phi, or it is expressed in a complex notation as R plus J XL. What does it mean? If R is represented with this real axis, where will be XL? It will be parallel to this imaginary axis. For inductive circuit, for RL circuit, for RL circuit, it will be in this particular direction. Right? From both of this parameter, we are getting Z. We are getting Z. This is the resultant of this R and this XL. Phi is the angle between these two. Okay. Next, we have to calculate the instantaneous power for this RL series circuit. We know that instantaneous power can be calculated by the formula P is equal to V into I. What is V? For RL circuit, it is Vm sin omega t. What is I? It is Im sin omega t minus phi. Do all the mathematical calculation. What we are getting? We are getting P is equal to 1 by 2 Vm Im into bracket cos phi minus cos 2 omega t minus phi. There are two components of the power. The first component will be Vm Im by 2 into cos phi minus Vm Im by 2 into cos of 2 omega t minus phi. The first term is also called as the constant power component, since there is no varying component, there is no omega t in this particular term. Whereas in the second term, there is cos of 2 omega t. Therefore, this term is also called as the fluctuating component of power. Whereas this fluctuating component is having frequency double than the supply frequency. This 2 is indicating double than the supply frequency. This will be the equation of instantaneous power for RL circuit. From this equation, if we need to calculate the average power of power equation, how to calculate it? Taking the average of first term and the average of second term. We know that the average of this second term over the complete cycle is 0, since it is having frequency double than the supplied frequency. Therefore, the average power will be, because of only first parameter, which was Vm Im cos phi by 2. We can rewrite the equation as Vm by root 2 Im by root 2 cos phi as it is. What is Vm by root 2? It is the RMS value of voltage. What is Im by root 2? It is RMS value of current. Therefore, power consumed by RL series circuit is given by the formula P is equal to VI cos phi. The power is measured in watts. We can also draw the waveforms. This is the voltage waveform. The black waveform is voltage waveform. The current was lagging to voltage by some angle phi. So, this brown waveform is current waveform. The power waveform will be the product of voltage into current. At this instant, current is 0. The next instant where any of the parameter is 0, take that interval. So, during this interval, both the parameters are positive. Therefore, power is also positive. Now, after this duration, the current is becoming 0 at this instant. So, taking this duration, during this current is positive but voltage is negative. Positive into negative, the product will be negative. Therefore, power is negative. Now, next, at this point, current is negative. Up to next, anything negative. Up to next, anything 0. Take that duration. So, current is 0. Here voltage is becoming 0 at this particular point. So, during this, both the quantities are negative. Therefore, negative into negative will become positive. Therefore, power is becoming positive. The inductor will store energy in this positive waveform. The inductor will return some energy in this negative. Since the positive is not exactly equal to negative, therefore, inductor is consuming power. For pure inductor, this positive half cycle and negative half cycle both were exactly equal to each other. Therefore, the power consumed by the inductor or the capacitor was equal to 0. But for RL circuit and RC circuit, the power is consumed by the circuit, which is given by P is equal to VI cos phi. See, positive power and negative power, both are not similar to each other. Okay, this was about the waveform. When the instantaneous power is asked in examination, it is expected to draw this waveforms as well. Okay, do remember. Next, we have to obtain the power triangle. Before going to power triangle, you should know what is power. In AC circuit, there are various powers. Real or active power, reactive power and apparent power. The real or active power in AC circuit is that power which does the useful work in the circuit. The active power does the useful work in the circuit, whereas the reactive power does not do any useful work. Reactive power does not do any useful work. The apparent power is the total power in the AC circuit. Apparent power is the total power in the AC circuit. We have to obtain formula for all the three powers. How to get this? We can get it from this phasor diagram. This is a voltage phasor. The current is lagging to the voltage phasor by an angle phi. We are splitting this current component. Okay. This is the positive x-axis component and this is the y-axis component. This is called as the real axis. This is called as imaginary axis. Okay. In real axis, this I will be equal to what? I cos phi. On imaginary axis, this I will be I sin phi. real power. Real power is due to the active component of current. Active component of current is what? I into cos phi. Therefore, it is called as active power or real power. It is denoted by letter capital P. Therefore, P is equal to what? P is the product of voltage into current. Voltage into active component of current or real component of current. The real component was I cos phi. It is also written as I square into R. I square into R. Real power does the useful work in the circuit. It is the power consumed by the resistance. And we know that the unit of the real power is watts. The new power to you is reactive power. It is the power due to reactive component of the current, which is called as reactive power. It is denoted by letter Q. Q is equal to voltage into current. Current, reactive component of current, which is given by I sin phi. It is also given as I square into XL. It does not do any useful work. It is the circulating power in L and C components. Okay. What will be the unit of reactive power? The unit of reactive power is volt ampere reactive, VAR. While checking the paper, we have observed that whenever the power is asked, blindly student write the unit watts. But do remember, here onwards, for real power you have to write watts, for reactive power you have to write VAR, volt ampere reactive. Okay, for apparent power the unit is volt ampere. What is apparent power? It is the total power in the circuit, denoted by the letter capital S, where S is equal to product of voltage into current, total voltage, total current, or it is also given as I square into Z. The unit of apparent power is volt amperes. This is volt, this is in ampere. So, volt ampere. So, from this basics of power, we have to obtain the power triangle for RL series circuit. How to obtain the power triangle? What is power triangle? All the three sides of the triangle showing the power is called as power triangle. The three powers was active power, reactive power and apparent power. Already we have obtained the impedance triangle. This is impedance triangle R, XL, Z. From this impedance triangle we can obtain the power triangle. How to obtain the power triangle? See, multiplying all the sides of impedance triangle by I square R, I square XL, I square into Z. What is I square R? I square R is nothing but active power, as I have shown you in the previous slide. What is I square into XL? It is equivalent to Q. What is I square into Z? It is S. This angle phi is as it is. So the triangle showing power in all the sides is called as the power triangle. Okay. The apparent power. Apparent power is total power. Mathematically, from this triangle, we can say S is equal to what? Square root of P square plus Q square. S is equal to square root of P square plus Q square. Power factor. From this triangle also, power factor is equal to what? Power factor is adjacent side divided by hypotenuse side. So P divided by S. What is P? P is real power divided by apparent power. Sometimes the real power, apparent power is given. It is asked to find out the power factor. So from this relation you can find out the power factor. Or else real power and cos phi is given. It is asked to find out the apparent power. So do remember this equation. This is also important equation. So this is what all about the RL series circuit. Okay. Hope you understood the same. So starting with the next, RC series circuit. Again, consider the AC circuit with a resistance R and the capacitance C farad. Both of them are connected in series as shown in this figure. The alternating voltage V, which is equal to Vm sin of omega t, is applied. The current flowing in the circuit is I. Say the voltage across the resistance. The voltage dropping across this resistance is Vr. The voltage across this capacitor is Vc. What is Vr? Vr is given by I into R. What is Vc? It is given by I into Xc. Again, we know that the voltage and current for pure resistance, both are in phase with each other. There is no phase angle between voltage and current. Therefore, both have been drawn in parallel to each other. The voltage across capacitor and the current through the capacitor. What is the relation between them? Current leads to the voltage by angle 90 degree. For pure capacitor, we know that current leads the capacitor voltage by angle 90 degree. With this information, we can have the phasor diagram. Again, the current is same. The current through the resistance, current through the capacitor is same. Since it is series circuit, therefore current phasor is taken as a reference phasor. Okay. The voltage Vr is drawn in parallel with this I or in the same axis with the I, since both of them are in phase with each other. The Vc is drawn lagging to I by angle 90 degree. Okay. Or the same, we can say current is leading the voltage by angle 90 degree. So from these two voltage Vr and this Vc, the vector addition of Vr and Vc gives the total voltage V. Okay. Therefore, this is the total voltage V. What is the relation between this voltage and current? See here. The voltage is lagging behind the voltage by angle phi. Or in the other words, we can say the current is leading to this voltage by angle phi. In RL circuit, the current was lagging. In RC circuit, the current is leading. From this voltage triangle, vector addition of Vr and Vc gives total voltage V. Or mathematically, V square is equal to Vr square plus Vc square, where Vr is equal to Ir and Vc is equal to I into Xc. We will be using this equation later on. Okay. Next, from the phasor diagram, we have to draw the waveforms. How to obtain the waveform? V is equal to Vm sin omega t and I is equal to Im sin of omega t plus phi. How I is equal to Im sin omega t plus phi? The current was leading to voltage by angle phi. For leading, which sign is there? For leading, plus sign is there. Okay. V is equal to Vm sin omega t. Therefore, the black waveform has started from the 0th instant, whereas the I waveform is showing plus phi. Plus phi means leading, which will come earlier. Therefore, before this voltage waveform, the current will start, and the angle between the starting of this voltage and starting of this current will be phi. This phi. Getting? The current will start before the voltage. Leading. The current is leading. It is a leader to voltage. Right? So, this is what about the waveforms. When it is asked to obtain this equation, how to obtain these equations? It can be obtained from this phasor diagram. Okay. After obtaining this equation, it is expected to draw this waveforms also. The next, from the voltage equations, V is equal to square root of Vr square and Vc square. Okay, is equal to V is equal to square root of Ir square. Vr is Ir and Vc is I into Xc. II is common in both, therefore taking I common, therefore V is equal to I into bracket R square plus XC square. What is this square root of R square plus XC square? This is called as impedance, same as in the previous case, which is also equal to V divided by I. It is measured in ohm. Impedance, opposing factor. Okay, Z is equal to R square plus XC square. For RC circuit, here XC will be there. For RL circuit, here XL will be there. Now from this we have to find out the phase angle phi and the power factor cos phi. What is phase angle phi? How to calculate the phase angle phi? Tan phi of this will give you the phase angle. Tan phi is equal to opposite side divided by the adjacent side. So VC divided by VR. From this what we are getting? XC divided by R. Therefore phi is equal to tan inverse of XC by R. Right? For RL circuit it was XL divided by R. Okay, you just need to replace the XL by XC. Next is power factor, cos phi. Cos phi is equal to what? Adjacent side divided by hypotenuse side. From this again what we are getting? It is the ratio of resistance to impedance. This is exactly same as the previous case. So at the last, the current is leading the applied voltage by angle phi in case of RC series circuit, whereas the voltage is equal to Vm sin omega t and Im is equal to Im sin omega t plus phi. Plus is indicating the leading current. Leading to what? Leading to voltage. Next we have to obtain the impedance triangle. How to obtain the impedance triangle? By dividing the voltage triangle by current. Divide this voltage triangle by current. V upon I will give you the impedance Z. VR upon I will give you the resistance R. And VC upon I will give you the capacitive reactance XC. And when all the three sides of the triangle are showing the opposition to the current parameter, such triangle is called as impedance triangle. Complex notation of impedance. Here V is equal to V at an angle 0 and I is equal to what? I at an angle plus phi. Current is leading, therefore plus phi. Therefore impedance is equal to, impedance was the ratio of V by I. V at an angle 0, I at an angle phi. V divided by I as it is. So this 0, when this phi is going to numerator, it will become minus. So this is minus of phi. Therefore impedance will become what? Z at an angle minus phi. Or in complex mode we can write it as R minus JXC, where R is drawn in parallel with this real axis. Where to draw this XC? Since this is a minus 1, for minus we have to draw the phasor in clockwise direction. J is indicating 90 degree, quadrature with the resistance. Therefore it is quadrature with the resistance. And the vector addition of these two gives the Z. Gives the Z. Are you getting this? So in general, the Z can be Z is equal to Z at an angle plus or minus phi. Or in complex mode we can write R is equal to plus minus J X. Right? This X can be XL or can be XC. If it is an inductive circuit, if it is an inductive circuit, this angle phi will be positive, right? And here the sign will be positive. If it is a capacitive circuit, this angle phi will be negative and this sign will also be negative, where this X will be XC. From these notations, we can draw the power waveforms. Okay, it is many a times, it is asked in exam, obtain the instantaneous power for the RC series circuit. How to obtain the instantaneous power? What is P? P is equal to the product of voltage into current. What is voltage? It is Vm sin of omega t. What is current? For RC circuit, it is Im sin omega t plus phi. Current is leading, therefore plus phi. Again do the same, this mathematical calculation. After doing so, what we are getting? There are two components of this power. The first component is constant component, whereas the second component is fluctuating component. This fluctuating component is having the frequency doubled than the applied frequency. Okay, so this will be the equation of instantaneous power. From this equation, you can obtain the average power. How to obtain the average power? The average of first component and the average of second component. The average of this second component or fluctuating component over a complete cycle is what? It is zero. Therefore, the average power consumed by the RC circuit is because of only the average of the first component, which is equal to what? Half of Vm Im cos phi. Mathematically, we can rewrite it as Vm by root 2 Im by root 2 cos phi. What is Vm by root 2? It is nothing but RMS value of voltage. What is Im by root 2? It is RMS value of current. Therefore, the average power consumed by RC circuit is also given by P is equal to Vi cos phi. Whereas the unit of power is watts. See, this is same as the power obtained from the RL circuit. The power absorbed in RL circuit, in RC circuit is same. It is P is equal to Vi cos phi. Next, it is expected to draw the waveforms of voltage, current and power as well. How to draw the waveforms? First, draw the voltage waveform. Okay. Then next, current is leading to the voltage. Leading means we have to draw current before the voltage. The phase difference between these two should be phi at all the instant. Okay. Then have the durations or intervals, and for the interval draw the power waveform. Take the product of this. When both voltage and current are positive, the power will be positive. When any one of the parameter is negative, the power will be negative. So here itself we can observe that the positive curve of the power is more than the negative curve. It means the RC circuit is absorbing more power. Okay, the positive and negative curve, both the curves are not equal. Therefore, we cannot say that the RC circuit is never consuming power. It is consuming the power. The next is power triangle for the RC circuit. How to obtain the power triangle? Same as the RL circuit. From the impedance triangle, we can obtain the power triangle. This is impedance triangle. Multiply all the sides of impedance triangle by I square. What is I square Z? I square Z is S, apparent power. I square R is P, real power. I square into X gives the reactive power Q. Apparent power mathematically square root of P square plus Q square, and cos phi is equal to real power to the apparent power. Okay. This is what about the RC series circuit. The next circuit is series RLC. RLC series circuit. Consider an AC circuit with a resistance R ohms, inductance L henries and capacitance C farad. All the parameters are connected in series as shown in this figure, and the alternating voltage V with the magnitude V is equal to Vm sin of omega t is applied to this combination. Say the current I is flowing through all the components. Since all of them are connected in series, therefore current will remain same. Say Vr is the voltage drop across the resistance, VL is the voltage drop across the inductor, and VC is the voltage drop across the capacitor. We know that for pure resistance, voltage and current both are in phase. Therefore, they are shown parallel to each other. For pure inductor, the current through inductor is lagging behind the voltage across inductor by angle 90 degree. For capacitive case, the current through the capacitor leads to the voltage across capacitor by angle 90 degree. So I is in phase with, VR is in phase with I, VL leading I by angle pi by 2 and VC lagging I by pi by 2. Mathematically we can say, what is V? This V is the vector addition of VR plus vector VL plus vector VC. There are three possible cases in this RLC series circuit. The first possible case is XL is greater than XC when the inductive reactance is greater than capacitive reactance. The second case is XL is less than XC. Inductive reactance is less than XC. The third case is both the reactances, inductive reactance and capacitive reactance, both are equal. We have to see all the three cases. The first case, when XL is greater than XC. When XL is greater than XC, obviously the VL will be greater than VC. Okay. So firstly, we'll draw the phasor diagram. Since the current was same through all the component, therefore current is taken as a reference phasor. Then VR is drawn. VR will be parallel to this current since both of them are in phase. Okay. What will be VL? Relation between VL and this I. The VL is leading to this current by 90 degree, or I is lagging to this VL by 90 degree. Next, VC. VC is lagging to this I by 90 degree, or we can say the current is leading to VC by angle 90 degree. After plotting this, the vector addition of VL and VC gives you the V. But we can see the VL and VC both are opposite to each other. Therefore, see here, we have considered the case 1 when VL is greater than VC. Therefore, taking this VC over here, so it will be VL minus VC component. Okay. This is equivalent to this component, VL minus VC. So vector addition of VR and VL minus VC will give you the total voltage V. And the angle between voltage and current is nothing but the phase angle. For this case, when XL is greater than XC or VL is greater than VC, what we are seeing? The voltage is leading to current by angle phi, or current is lagging behind the voltage by angle phi. When the circuit is more inductive, see, XL is greater than XC, means this is inductive circuit. And in inductive circuit, we have seen that the current is lagging. Therefore, here also, the current is lagging behind this voltage by angle phi. Okay. Then mathematically, this V square is equal to what? VR square plus this VL minus VC square, which is written here. What is VR? It is IR. What is VL minus VC square? VL is I into XL and VC is I into XC. Taking I common like this. Okay. Therefore, the equation will become V divided by this I. What is V by I? V by I is nothing but impedance Z. This is equal to square root of R square into bracket plus XL minus XC square. So, this bracket is showing the impedance. Say this XL minus XC is equal to X. Therefore, Z is equal to what? It is square root of R square plus XC square. Where this X is net reactance, XL minus XC. Where phase angle phi is equal to what? Tan inverse of reactive component divided by resistance. Okay. For first case, when XL is greater than XC, this X is equal to what? XL minus XC. Subtracting the smaller term from the higher term. Okay. Now the next case. The next case is XC is greater than XL. XC is greater means what? Voltage across capacitor is greater than voltage across the inductor. Therefore, the net voltage will be along the negative Y axis. So this is VC minus VL. Okay. This is nothing but VC minus VL. We can plot this VC minus VL right here also. So the vector addition of VR and this VC minus VL will give you the total voltage V. So this is the total voltage and this is the total current. What is the relation between voltage and current? The current is leading to this voltage by angle phi. Whenever there is more capacitive circuit, the current will be leading. Again the same, we have to do all the same thing. Instead of XL minus XC, just put XC minus XL. Since here XC is greater, therefore XC minus XL. The net reactance will be XC minus XL. That is the only difference. Okay, this will be the second case. Under the third case, the third case is XL is equal to XC. Obviously, the VL is equal to VC. Both of them will cancel each other. Okay, therefore, the net voltage or the resultant voltage is nothing but VR. The net voltage or resultant voltage is nothing but VR. Since VL and VC are cancelling each other. Therefore, what will be phase angle phi? What is the relation between voltage and current? They are parallel to each other. Right? Or we can say there is no phase angle between these two. Therefore, phi is equal to 0. The third case. VL is equal to VC. When XL is equal to XC, the total voltage is nothing but VR. V is equal to, what is VR? It is I into R. From this, Z is equal to R. Okay, there is no X. XL, X is equal to XL minus XC or XC minus XL. Both are cancelling to each other. Therefore, the total impedance is because of only resistance. Okay, means impedance is reducing. When impedance is reducing, the current will increase, right? And the phase angle is 0. This is what all about the series RLC circuit. The next is resonance in series RLC circuit. This is what the third condition only. Resonance is a condition in a series RLC circuit in which the capacitive and inductive reactances are equal in magnitude. Thus they cancel each other and result in a purely resistive impedance. This is just like the third case of the RLC series circuit. Okay. When XL is equal to XC, we can say that it is resonance in RLC series circuit. Many a times, the resonant frequency has been asked in examination. How to find out the resonant frequency? There is a simple derivation for this. In this case, XL is equal to XC. What is XL? XL is equal to omega L. What is XC? It is 1 upon omega C. So omega into omega, it will become omega square. Okay, is equal to 1 divided by C, taking this L to denominator. So 1 by LC. Since this omega is representing the resonance condition, therefore we are taking small r as a resonance condition. So omega r, taking square root of this equation, omega r is equal to 1 divided by square root of LC. Okay, what is omega? Omega is 2 pi f. Therefore from this, fr is equal to what? 1 divided by 2 pi square root of LC. The frequency is measured in hertz. So this is the resonance frequency for the series RLC circuit. When the RLC series circuit is under the resonance condition, these are the important points. The net reactance of the circuit X will become 0. Since XL is equal to XC, X, which is XL minus XC or XC minus XL, obviously will become 0. The circuit impedance will be minimum. Why it will be minimum? Because from this impedance, the X part is 0. Okay, therefore it is minimum. When impedance is minimum, when opposition is minimum, obviously the current will be maximum. Okay, which is the opposing factor for the current. Therefore, the circuit current is maximum under the resonance condition and is given by what? I is equal to V divided by Z, or Z is equivalent to R, therefore V divided by R. The power dissipated under this condition is also maximum. Since current is maximum, therefore power is also maximum, which is given by the formula I square into R. The circuit power factor angle phi will be 0. Since Z and R both are equal, therefore phi is equal to 0 and power factor is equal to unity or 1. Although VL is equal to VC, yet V coil is greater than VC because of its resistance. If we need to plot the various graphs against the frequency, the graph of impedance, XL, XC, resistance, net reactance, this is the graph. Suppose an alternating voltage of constant magnitude but varying frequency is applied to RLC circuit. The variation of resistance, inductance, capacitive reactance along with the frequency can be shown by this graph. What is resistance? The resistance is independent of the frequency. There is no frequency in the formula of resistance, therefore it is independent of frequency. Hence the resistance will be a constant. If the frequency is changing from 0 to maximum value, there will not be any effect on the resistance. Inductive reactance, XL. What is the formula for XL? It is 2 pi FL. Okay. XL is directly proportional to F. Means as the frequency is increasing, linearly the XL will also increase. So this is the XL graph. XC. XC is given by what? 1 divided by omega C or 1 divided by 2 pi FC. It is inversely proportional to each other. When frequency is minimum, the XC will be maximum. Okay. As the frequency is increasing, the XC will reduce in the negative fashion. At maximum frequency, the XC will be minimum. The net reactance, X. The net reactance is given by XL minus XC or XC minus XL. Okay. So, this is what the XL minus XC. See here, I have shown the FR. FR is the resonant frequency. At this frequency, we can say XL should be equal to XC. So, graphically we can also see this XL is equal to this XC. Impedance. Impedance is square root of R square plus this X square. So, this is what the impedance curve. It is also called as the V curve. Then current. Current will be inward to Z. So, this is the current curve. This is all about the R, L, C combinations, RL, RC and RLC circuit and the RLC resonance condition.